Like these, there are about 30 looming red flags if you are in a relationship with someone who is unknowingly toxic for you. This book talks specifically about relationship because it's not just about love and commitment, it's also about your self-awareness, your sanity and your well-being in a relationship. So let's take a quick look at the book. Psychopath Free, the expanded edition, was first published in the year 2015 under the genre of self-help book. It talks about relationships with narcissists, sociopaths and toxic people. It's written by Jackson McKenzie, who is author of another book called Whole Again and co-founder of psychopathfree.com, an online support community that reaches millions of abuse survivors each month. He has his bachelor's in computer and information sciences. Driven by personal experience, McKenzie's mission is to spread awareness and give survivors a safe place to validate their experience so that every person can find happiness and love. I'm going to review the book and put my opinion before going to the contents of the book. The cover and build of the book, that is its content, and the summary at the back is going to give you the urge of reading through the book, because I feel at some point or the other we have come across the experience of dealing with a psychopath, if not in a relationship with them. Thus, the message on top and at the back is quite strong and precise. Going inside the book, it tells you about the basic criteria of differentiating a toxic person, or whether you are already involved with someone like that, and then building a solid and strong awareness within you about the same. According to me, I could relate much with this phase where the author tells you how to differentiate or what are the basic things by which you can kind of start doubting whether that person is really, or investigating whether that person is really toxic for you or not, because the points were very genuine and properly explained. But at some instances, I started doubting genuine people in my life, whether they are toxic for me or not. But that can happen with you too if you are reading the book, but as you go on reading, the writer clears all the doubt and then it just flies off. Then the author talks about how a psychopath weaves his or her way to your heart and why suddenly you are involved so much in this overflowing love and care, and how it may be bad for you. The author strongly says that every good thing is bound to take some time. Like time to build trust, time to build communication, time to build understanding, and also time to have or be comfortable. But if all of this is happening in a very, very fast way where you don't have the time to react or even grasp it, then maybe it's not all genuine. It may be so that the psychopath is just mirroring you. Because this is one thing that psychopaths always do. Rather than being their own self or showing the person they really are, they just mirror your dreams, your ideas, your point of view, so that you like that very quickly connect with each other. But it's just on the surface and very shallow, and that mirroring effect of the psychopath in some days will definitely go away. So once you feel that the mirroring effect of the psychopath is no more there, then you will find them talking to other people in a way that they should talk to you. You will feel that they are spending time someplace else, they are lying. Like for example, they say that they are going to the gym, but somehow they end up having dinner with their friends. So these petty things, you will see that they are not sharing with you, and in the process, you will start getting a little jealous, a little anxious. So in this, and then the psychopath will enjoy this change in you, where you are kind of always wanting them, desperate for them. So they enjoy this feeling. This is how the psychopath will slowly erode your personality, erode the patience in you, and erode the actual person that you were before you came into relationship with them. And it's all planned in the psychopath. So they will, what the book says is that they will show that they're innocent and all of this is just happening by chance, and then they have nothing to do there. But what the author says that if the person is really toxic and psychopath, then all of it is pre-planned, and they are very precisely and very with lot of thinking, they are planning these steps. to destroy you emotionally and then go off to the next person and do the same thing with them. Because for them, for psychopaths specifically in a relationship, all these are just a game. Apart from being an attention seeker, the psychopath also blames you every time you try to have a discussion with them on something that has happened in your relationship. But whenever you try to do so, they point out your flaws, saying that you are jealous, you are anxious, and you are not the person whom they met the first time they came into the relationship. They are going to demean you, they are going to be rude to you, and then they'll emotionally abuse you, and every time they'll take a reference of their old relationship where they were being abused and then start comparing you with his or her ex. So you just try to be quiet and not confront them ever, even if they are doing something wrong, because you know that even if you try to confront them, then they are just going to stop talking to you. Slowly you will realize that the person who used to be so close to you, who used to understand you without even words, suddenly is turning into a stranger and spending time with other people and acting strangely with you, is not having any proper conversations with you, and blaming you often whenever you try to have a conversation with them. So these are all a few criteria where the author has said that you may start thinking that maybe she is not that much not toxic for you. So I could relate to this part of the book where the author is differentiating a toxic person, and I felt about the writing style, I felt that he is very repetitive in his writing. So it can be a good thing also, a bad thing also. So it's good for people who are really, really in a toxic relationship, because it's like a constant hammering to their brain to wake up and see the reality. But it's not that much interesting for readers like me, who are here just for the love of reading. Thus, I would recommend this book strongly for people who are not happy in their relationship, who feel that they are emotionally being abused, emotionally they are suppressed, and their voices are not heard. So this book is very much an eye-opener to you, I believe. So yeah, I recommend these for people in relationship, but people who are not in relationship, I don't think this book is ideal for them. Because if you are not having any problem, then what would you do with the solution? But still, if you want to give it a read, you can give it a read. So in the second part of the book, the author talks about how you can come out of the relationship like this. So it is divided into three parts. One is how you identify a toxic or a psychopath. And then number two, what is the grieving phase? It is divided into two phases, and the authors have given all the symptoms of the phase and why it takes such a long time to recover from a relationship with a psychopath. And then number three, the author talks about freedom when you have already recovered and what are the signs of recovery and healthy life. The author has strictly asked to practice self-care. So there are a few self-care tactics in the book which I would read out to you. Practice meditation whenever you can. Take a multivitamin with B-complex each day. This will ensure you are receiving all the nutrition you need. B6 and B12 can help to combat depression. Fish oil is an excellent supplement to keep your skin and hair strong, but it also has some great antidepressant qualities. Exercise. Go for a walk every day. Spend half an hour at the gym. Don't worry if your workout is less intense than it used to be. To this day, now he shares one story of himself. That to this day, my friends still refuse to go to the gym with me because I mostly just roll around on the exercise ball and giggle. Eat three meals a day, even when you are not hungry. And wake up at reasonable hour each morning. You don't want to get stuck in the habit of rolling out of the bed in the afternoon, too depressed to face the day. Get 7 to 9 hours of sleep. Adequate rest is essential to your mental health. And then take care of your basic hygiene each day. Don't skip out on brushing your teeth or taking a shower. The more you get into a routine, the easier it will be to form a good habit. So that's all for today's video. And I would give this book a 4 out of 5 because I saw reviews where many people gave 5 out of 5 and they appreciated the book. But why 4? Because I'm not dealing with any psychopath right now. I'm not into a relationship. I'm not into a relationship with a psychopath. So I just give it 4 out of 5. Otherwise, it's a good book. I recommend it for people in a relationship. Thank you. Bye.